Hello everyone, my name is Werner Vogels and I'm the Chief Technology Officer of Amazon. I'm speaking to you today from a rather warm Dubai. I'd like to congratulate Sabanji University on the opening of their digital campus and thank them for the invitation to speak today. The age of digital learning is upon us. Advances in digital technologies provide a range of ways for students to engage like never before. The opening of this digital campus demonstrates the commitment of Sabanji University and Sabanji Group to the leadership necessary in today's innovation environment. Sabanji's digital campus is the accumulation of several different trends that I see. These will be significant drivers of change that will shape our institutions and our lives in the decades to come. And Sabanji Digital Campus will be a key part of bringing these innovations to life in Turkey, one of the world's most vibrant and historic countries. Over the last 18 months, everything we've known has been put to test due to the onset of the COVID-19 pandemic. As communities grappled with the challenges and opportunities of remote learning, the potential advantages and all-too-real pain points presented themselves. In 2020, whether you were a data scientist or not, we all got a glimpse of this growing data curve. As scientific researchers, pharmaceutical companies, governments, and healthcare institutions turned every resource towards developing vaccines, novel treatments, and other means to help the world stay healthy during the pandemic. Technology was at the center of all these efforts, and it required generating and processing vast amounts of data. Whether in healthcare or other applications, the only realistic way to handle all the information we are seeing is to use ingestion and aggregation tools married to machine learning models that can help make sense of it. This same data curve and technology opportunity is especially true in education. For years, educators have considered the optimal role of the internet in the classroom. From plagiarism checkers to dials and buzzers to provide instant feedback in classes, the experiences of educators and students through this pandemic have shown both the need for such technologies as well as shown their current limitations. As students and instructors increasingly come from generations who have grown up with technology, education must evolve to meet the needs and expectations of these digital natives. To prepare students for their post-academic careers that increasingly rely on technology, education must evolve. But how does it evolve in a way that truly meets the needs? Is it more than simply broadcasting lectures through a web browser? Machine learning and artificial intelligence are both promising applications of technology in education. Imagine bridging the physical world of classrooms with digital technologies, where sensors and algorithms can help instructors better predict and understand when students may benefit from more support or a closer engagement. Imagine the ability to use more natural human interfaces, such as voice interaction, for all aspects of learning. Natural language processing and speech synthesis can be used to support a diverse range of student tasks to improve both teaching and learning experiences. Voice-mediated computing can also relieve faculty from more tedious roles and allow them instead to focus on working with students more closely and more effectively. For example, pioneering work is being done using Alexa to provide students with grammar feedback, freeing professors to concentrate their time and attention on the content of papers and other work. And while writing is still essential, the explosion of digital work and schooling has only accentuated an increasing reliance on non-textual communication. For example, on an average day on Twitter, around 80% of messages contain some kind of image or video. Just as companies increasingly seek to meet customer demands for new, non-keyboard ways of interacting with products and services, education experiences should also be made more multidimensional and responsive to different learning styles and preferences. This can be particularly useful for students who struggle with learning disabilities or maybe difficulties processing text. This is an area ripe for innovation, and it has been enabled by the rapid reduction in the cost and the rapid expansion in the capabilities to store and work with data in the cloud. Sabancı's Digital Campus will provide a base for deployment, experimentation, and refinement for iteration of these exciting technological breakthroughs in education. Other education ideas that have been discussed for years now become feasible thanks to the advances in computing. Imagine flipping the classroom, where face-to-face discussions and collaborative work are more the focus of classroom time, and lectures and individual work shift to being completely remote via technical mediation. This can be enabled by the remote delivery of content, real-time monitoring of student feedback, and voice and language analysis. Or imagine using ML and AI as a supplement to marking. This can go way beyond relieving faculty and student fatigue on low-level issues, but it can be used to better understand assignments and lesson delivery, to predict when students may be disengaging or falling behind. This is just the tip of the iceberg what can be done in education. And I believe that these types of innovations that will happen at the digital campus will lead to advancements that will be key in developing education, industry, and society as we move into a new era in technology. I'm inspired by the steps that Sabancı has taken in leading this new digital learning era and continuing the university's tradition of excellence. It's my pleasure to be with you here today, virtually, as Sabancı University celebrates the opening of the digital campus. Thank you for the invitation, and best of luck.